I never knew. I never knew that everything was falling through. That everyone I knew was waiting on a cue to turn and run when all I needed was the truth. But that's how it's gotta be. It's coming down to nothing more than apathy. You're ever on the other way to say we'll see. Smoking with the
soda and vinegar, or basically sodium, hydrogen, carbonate, and acetic acid. And here's the symbolic piece here, NaHCO3 plus H3COOH plus CO2 and H2O and CH3COON. And basically what that is sodium, hydrogen, carbonate plus acetic acid yields carbon dioxide plus dihydrogen monoxide plus sodium acid. There's a double replacement reaction that gives off gas, which is the CO2. It leaves water, and it leaves sodium acetate. And that's why you see a liquid left after, and that's why you see bubbles coming out of the CO2 gas escape. All right, so at the nano level, when the sodium hydrogen carbonate reacts with the acetic acid, sodium replaces hydrogen, and the hydrogen is left with and another hydrogen from the sodium hydrogen comes out and forms H2O with one oxygen from the sodium hydrogen carbonate. And so we have H2O there. CO2 is formed by one of the carbons from the sodium hydrogen carbonate and the two remaining oxygens. And the sodium hydrogen is formed by one sodium atom combining with the H3COO. And because we already lost that hydrogen to H2O, it forms the sodium.
So my reaction was the creation of the battery and the chemical reaction of what's going on within the battery. And on the macro level, it's two different metals with different activities, one more reactive, one less reactive, reacting in electrolytic solutions to create electrical energy in order to light an LED. And our two different metals we used were copper and zinc. Copper being the less reactive, zinc being the more reactive. And this is an oxidation-reduction reaction. And at the nano level, we know that electrons are flowing from the anode to the cathode, and anodes and cathodes are electrodes, and an anode is a negatively charged electrode, and a cathode is a positively charged electrode. So the electrons are flowing from one to the other, and in this case, they would be flowing from zinc to copper, because zinc is an anode and copper is a cathode. And the symbolic piece of this part of our RUBE Goldberg is we did half reactions, so we did the oxidation part and the reduction part, and zinc is the one being oxidized because it's losing electrons, and this is its equation, zinc 2+. And then the reduction is of copper because copper is gaining electrons in this because electrons are flowing from this to this. And the voltage of our reaction in order to light the LED was 1.10 volts.
Okay, so this is the Mentos and Diet Coke reaction. It is a physical reaction. For the macro, we see the Coke bubbling, caused by CO2 gas being produced. This reaction is very fast, and the entropy or disorder increases because it is a liquid to gas. The nano, the structure of the Mentos is the most significant cause of the eruption due to nucleation. The surface of the Mentos is rough and littered with many small holes that increase the surface area available for reaction. This means the number of reagents exposed to each other at any given time also increases. This allows CO2 bubbles to attach to the rough surfaces of the Mentos and to form quickly in such a great number that the CO2 gas is able to escape. The geyser-like display is the result of this process. And here I drew a very interesting example of what this might look like, but the black here represents the dips in the Mentos, the small holes on the surface, and the molecules of CO2 represent the CO2 gas that are attaching to the rough surface in order to escape. And the symbolic is a CO2 aqueous into CO2 gas. And that's it.